Thank you so much for that very special introduction.
谢谢这么特别的一个介绍。
It has been a great joy to be with you these last few days.
在过去三天能够和大家在一起是我极大的喜乐。
We had a wonderful time with the youth this morning.
今天早上我们和年轻人也有非常美好的时间。
And young people, as promised, I posted your video on my Facebook page.
那么我向年轻人保证，我会把他们的照片放在他的这个面部上面。
Make sure you visit there. Ask Dr. Brown on Facebook.
所以你一定要去看看哈，就是这个 Ask Dr. Brown 这个 Facebook.
But Pastor, you have me wondering about something.
那牧师，你让我想起一些东西。
I watched that trailer about vision.
我看了这个关于世界的广告。
I saw you levitating someone.
我看到你使一些人漂浮在空中。
Can you levitate someone as big as me?
你可以使我这么大只的一个人在空中漂浮吗？
It's my honor to be here as a Jew.
作为一个犹太人，我很荣幸能够来这边。
For 22 straight years, I've gone to India.
有22年的时间，我到印度去。
And my first trip there, we were having a meal at someone's home.
那么我第一次到印度呢，在一个人的家里吃饭。
The man had not been able to sleep all night.
那个人呢，是整个晚上没办法睡觉。
His wife was so excited she couldn't sleep.
他的太太很兴奋，因为他不能睡觉的缘故。
We came to the door of his house.
我们来到他的家门口。
And he said this to me.
他这样对我说
：“You are the second Jew to come into my home.
你是第二个犹太人来到我的家的。
The first Jew was Jesus Christ.
第一个犹太人是耶稣基督。”
So my older brother has been here already.
我的长兄啊，已经到过了这个地方。
But it is great to be with you.
但是非常高兴和大家在一起。
Please pray as we reach out to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
为我们祷告，因为我们要把以色列家迷失的羊找回来。
The Jewish people around the world are under very intense pressure right now.
全世界的犹太人面对非常大的压力。现在
，Antisemitism is rising worldwide, just as it did before the Holocaust.
全世界正在兴起一股这个反犹太人的这种势力。
But more than anything, Jews need to discover Jesus as their Messiah.
但更重要的，犹太人要认识耶稣就是弥赛亚。
When you think of it, pray that God would use us. The harvest is very ripe.
那你为我们祷告，因为这个禾场已经熟透了。
I have a very important message to bring to you today.
今天我有一个很重要的信息要传讲。
I want to deal with an area of great controversy in the body.
那么是处理在基督的肢体里面一个非常大的这个冲突和矛盾。
It is a subject of foundational importance in each of our lives.
这个课题是我们每一个人生命里面基础性的非常重要的一个课题。
It is what we call hyper grace.
我们称为这个极端的恩典。
Is the message of grace in Scripture, but exaggerated?
那么是太过强调了这个恩典这方面的课题。
It is the message of grace in Scripture, but with additions that can be very destructive.
他们加了一些东西在圣经的关于恩典这方面的信息里面，那么那是非常让人困扰的。
Because I love God's grace so much, I'm jealous for pure grace.
因为我这么爱神的恩典，以致我产生嫉妒。
Let's turn to Titus chapter 2.
让我们翻开提多书第二章。
Titus chapter 2.
提多书第二章。
And let's believe that God would open our hearts and open our minds to receive the truth of His Word.
我们相信神会敞开我们的心，我们的眼睛，让我们领受他的话语。
I love grace.
我爱恩典。
I reject hyper grace.
但是我拒绝这个极端的恩典。
I am not anti grace.
我不是反恩典。
It is because I believe in grace that I am so jealous for it.
因为我相信恩典，以致我对这个恩典是产生了这种嫉妒。
Paul writes about grace more than anyone else in the Bible.
在圣经里面，保罗提到恩典比任何人更多。
And he makes this amazing statement in Titus chapter 2.
在提多书第二章，他讲了这个非常奇妙的一些话。
Beginning in verse 11.
从第十一节开始。
For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men.
因为神救众人的恩典已经显明出来。
Through the cross of Jesus, God's grace has appeared to all men.
教训我们除去不敬虔的心和世俗的情欲。
When Jesus died on the cross for us, God was shouting out His love.
当耶稣在十字架上钉死的时候，其实是神在向全世界呼喊他的爱。
We sinned.
我们得罪神。
We were guilty.
我们有罪了。
We rebelled.
我们悖逆他。
We deserved death.
我们是配得死亡的。
Before I knew Jesus, I was a heavy drug user.
我信耶稣之前，我是一个吸毒者。
I was full of pride and uncleanness.
我非常的不洁净，而且充满着骄傲。
I even stole money from my own father.
甚至我从父亲那里偷钱。
In God's sight, I deserve death.
在神的面前，我是应该被处死的。
But instead of us dying, God's son died for us.
但是，因为我们其实应该死的，但是神的儿子为我们死了。
Every wrong thing you've ever done, Jesus paid the price for.
你所做的每一件错的事情，耶稣都为你付出代价。
And through the cross, God's grace has appeared to all men.
透过神的恩典，透过十字架，神的恩典临到所有人。
Verse 12.
十二节。
It teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly passions and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in this present age.
教训我们除去不敬虔的心和世俗的情欲，在今世自守公义，敬虔度日。
God's grace does not give us an excuse to sin.
神的恩典并不是我们犯罪的一个借口。
God's grace does not make light of sin.
神的恩典并不是使这个罪更轻了。
God's grace nails our sin to the cross.
神的恩典把我们的罪钉在十字架上。
God's grace pours out forgiveness on us.
神的恩典把他的赦免临到我们众人。
And God's grace teaches us to say no to sin.
神的恩典使我们能够对罪说不。
In fact, God's grace gives us special power to overcome sin.
实际上，神的恩典给我们特别的能力，能够胜过罪。
Everything I just said, hyper grace teachers also say.
我所说的这一切，极端的恩典那班人所说的也是有这一切。
They believe these very same things.
他们相信同样的东西。
They don't believe that grace gives us an excuse to sin.
他们不相信这个恩典给我们有犯罪的借口。
But because there are several fundamental errors in their message, it often leads people to sin.
但是因为在他们信息里面有一些基本的错误，往往使人去犯罪。
I am involved in controversy almost every day of my life.
我几乎每一天都面对这些冲突或者是不同的东西。
If you'll search for me online, you'll find many people who love me and many people who hate me.
如果你上网查一查的话，你会看到很多人喜欢我，也有很多人不喜欢我。
But I'm not looking for trouble.
但是我不是自找麻烦。
I'm not looking for controversy.
我不是要针对不同的东西。
God has not made me the policeman to enforce His truth on the body of Christ.
神不是使我成为警察，在基督的肢体里面强调一些东西。
But controversies come to me.
但是这些矛盾冲突来到了面前。
And the issue of hyper grace began to come to me.
那么这个极端的恩典也临到我的身上。
I would post something on social media encouraging people to pursue holiness.
我会在公众媒体上面放一些东西，让人追求圣洁。
After all, that's written in the Word.
因为这是神的话语所告诉我们的。
We're called to pursue holiness.
神呼召我们去追求圣洁。
And I would exhort people to do it.
我会鼓励人去这样做。
And someone would respond.
有些人会反应。
I'm already holy.
我已经圣洁了。
You're not going to throw your legalism on me.
你不要把你这个律法主义强加在我身上。
You're not going to condemn me.
你不要定我的罪。
You're not going to call me into some type of works righteousness in the flesh.
你不要使我进到这个肉体上面的自以为意。
And I would think to myself,
我会想一想
That's strange.
这很奇怪啊。
I just quoted a verse from the Bible.
我是引用圣经来跟他们讲话。
Why are you attacking me?
为什么你攻击我呢？
I began to find people reacting.
我看到一些人有反弹。
The moment I would exhort them to press into God.
当我鼓励他们要在神里面坚持的时候
If I encourage them to live a life that pleased the Lord
鼓励他们过讨神喜悦的生活的时候
They would react against me
他们会有反弹
I'm not going to strive
啊，我不会去争取
I'm already completely pleasing in the Lord
我在神的面前已经完全蒙他悦纳了
There's nothing I could do that could displease God
我没有可以做什么事来使神不喜悦的
I began to meet people
我开始去见一些人。
And years past, they used to be full of fire for the Lord.
那么这个牧师是对神充满着热情、火热的。
They used to share the gospel with everyone.
他向每一个人分享福音。
But now they were just resting.
现在他们在休息。
Just resting in the Lord.
在主里面休息。
They weren't praying anymore.
他们不再祷告了。
They weren't sharing the gospel anymore.
他们不再传福音了。
Their standards of holiness were dropping.
他们圣洁的标准越来越低落。
They had discovered God's grace.
他们发现了神的恩典。
I said something's wrong here.
我说这有点不对了。
And I began to look at some of the teaching.
我就开始看他们的一些教导。
I began to read some of the books.
我读他们的一些书本。
And I prayed.
我祷告。
I said, Lord, am I missing something?
主啊，我有没有错失了一些东西呢？
Is there a revelation of grace that I'm missing?
是不是你？恩典的这个启示，有些东西我忽略了。
I didn't come to criticize and attack.
我没有攻击，也没有批判他们。
But the more I read and the more I listened, the more concerned I became.
但是我越多去读，越多听他们的信息的时候，我越感觉到关心。
Some people say this.
有些人这样说。
It is impossible to exaggerate grace.
这个恩典呢，是你没有办法再夸张的。
God's grace is hyper. God's grace is over and above.
啊，神的恩典是超越一切的。
Ah, the fact is, you can exaggerate anything.
事实是，你可以夸张任何东西。
You can exaggerate the love of God until there's no hell.
你可以夸张神的爱，说啊，没有这个地狱。
You can exaggerate the holiness of God until it's impossible for anyone to be saved.
你可以夸张神的圣洁，以致没有任何人可以得救。
Or you can just teach on one truth and leave out other truths, and you will become spiritually imbalanced.
你可以强调一个恩典啊，一个真理，那么却活出另外一个真理，以致你的生活没有平衡。
The error of hyper grace is spreading around the world.
这个极端的恩典的信息在全世界在传播。
I have been asked by leaders in country after country, please come to our country and address this because it is spreading and harming many.
不同的国家的领袖来对我说，你来跟我们分享啊你的心得，因为这个信息正在伤害许多的人。
I've written a whole book about it if you want to find out more.
我有一本书啊，写到关于这个极端的恩典的。如果你想知道更多的话
，But in this message, I want to explain the fundamental error of hyper grace.
在这篇信息里面，我要讲到关于这个极端的恩典一些基本的错误。
And then I want to show you where it can lead.
然后我要让你看到这样的错误能够使我们走到怎么样的一个地步。
But first, let me boast about the grace of God.
但首先让我先夸耀一下神的这个恩典。
Many of us don't understand it.
很多人不了解神的恩典。
Many of us live our whole Christian lives thinking, I'm not good enough.
很多人他一生过着基督徒的生活，都在想自己不够好。
Many of you go to sleep at night thinking, God's just not happy with me.
可能你晚上睡觉，你觉得神不高兴我今天所做的事。
I didn't pray enough.
我祷告的不够。
I didn't love my neighbor enough.
我爱邻舍爱的不够。
I didn't share the gospel enough.
我没有啊去传福音传的够。
I have to try harder.
我要更努力的传福音。
God's not happy with me.
神不高兴我这样做。
And you feel almost like he's standing there with a whip over you.
你觉得好像有一个鞭子一直在鞭你一样。
I absolutely believe in working for God.
我绝对相信我们要为神工作，服侍神。
I believe in running my race so as to win.
我相信我们赛跑是为了得胜。
I want to live every day so it will make sense in the light of eternity.
我要活着每一天在永恒里面是被计算的。
But I don't do it to receive God's favor.
但是我做并是为了得着神的恩典。
I do it because I already have His favor.
我这样做是因为我已经领受了神的恩典。
I want you to consider this.
我要你想一想。
Let's say you were living the way I was living.
假设你的生活跟我是一样的话
A wicked, sinful life without God.
一个邪恶、罪恶的生活没有神
16 years old.
16岁的年纪
I ask God to forgive me of my sins.
我求神
wash
赦免我的罪
Wash me clean.
把我洗干净
Make me a new person.
使我成为一个新造的人
Accept me as your child.
接纳我成为他的儿子。
I want you to consider this.
我要你想一想。
At that very moment,
在那一刻。
At that moment, God accepted me as His child.
在那一刻，神就接纳我成为他的孩子。
I went from death to life.
我从死亡进到生命。
From a child of God, from a child of Satan to a child of God.
从撒旦儿子成为神的儿子。
One moment I was condemned.
这个刻我被定罪。
The next moment I was forgiven.
另一刻我被赦免了
One moment I was guilty
这一刻我是有罪的
The next moment righteous
另一刻我成为公义的
If you don't have a personal relationship with God
如果你和神没有建立这个个人的关系
If your sins have not yet been forgiven
如果你的罪还没有被赦免
You can work hard for the rest of your life and never earn God's forgiveness
你可以努力工作一生但是却没有领受到神的爱
But in one moment of time God forgives you and washes you clean
但是就在那一刻神接纳你把你洗干净
Think of it
想想看
I hadn't done anything yet
我什么都没有做
I hadn't gone home and thrown out my drugs
我没有回家把我的毒品丢掉
I haven't confessed my sins to my father
我还没有向我的父亲认罪
I hadn't done anything
我什么都没有做
I just asked God for mercy
我只是求神的恩典。
And at that moment, He gave me salvation as a free gift.
那个他把这个救恩临到我的身上，是一种免费的礼物。
At that moment, He declared me righteous.
在那一刻，他宣告我是一个义人。
At that moment, He declared me holy.
在那一刻，他宣告我是圣洁的。
When Paul writes in the New Testament,
当保罗写新约的时候
he doesn't say to all the sinners in Corinth,
他不是对着那些罪人在讲话
he says to the saints in Corinth,
他是对着那些罪
that Greek word means holy ones,
那个希腊字就是圣洁的
now, here's what happened in my own life,
那我的生命就是曾经发生过这样的事
God convicted me about shooting heroin and living the life I was living.
那么神让我看到自己打这个海洛因是不对的。
I went home, I threw the needles out.
我回家就把那个针筒丢掉了。
I was absolutely saved.
我完全得救了。
Absolutely born again.
再重生了。
But I wasn't really thinking about other drugs.
但是我还在想那些毒品。
Two days later, I smoked a drug.
两天之后我吸毒。
Please hear me.
听清楚了。
I was saved.
我已经得救了。
I was a believer.
我是一个信徒。
I was forgiven.
我被赦免了。
I was righteous.
我是公义的。
I was absolutely brand new.
我是一个完完全全新造的人。
I wasn't even thinking about this.
我完全没有想到这一点。
And I felt convicted.
我觉得自己有这个信念。
I shouldn't do this.
我不应该这样做。
I said, Lord, I'm done with that.
主啊。我已经放弃这一切了。
A few weeks later, the Holy Spirit convicted me about my tongue.
那么几个礼拜之后，圣灵又说我的这个口舌有问题。
I used to use all types of bad speech.
我讲所有那些坏话。
I didn't know it was wrong.
我不知道我是错了。
I was brand new.
我是一个新造的人。
I was completely ignorant.
我是完全无知的。
What does that mean?
这表示什么呢
？Even when I was doing wrong things, I was still forgiven.
就算我做错了事，我还是被饶恕。
I was still a child of God.
我还是神的孩子。
I was still clean.
我还是清洁的。
I was still righteous.
我还是公义的。
And when I realized this was displeasing to the Lord,
当我发现我所做的不讨神的喜悦，
I immediately turned away from it.
我马上改变。
I didn't need to get saved again.
我不需要再重新得救。
Oh God.
哦，主啊。
I thought a wrong thought.
我想错了东西。
I have to go back and get saved all over again.
我必须再回来，再重新得救。
I have to come to the altar.
我必须来到你的祭坛面前。
I have to pray the sinner's prayer.
我必须再做这个认罪的祷告。
No, you're already saved.
不需要，你已经得救了。
You're already forgiven.
你已经被赦免了。
You just need to confess that to God and be cleansed and move on.
你只要向神承认你所做的错误的事情，那么你就继续生活下去。
It is so important that we understand that God's grace brings us into a different place with God.
我们要知道神的恩典使我们进到另外的一个境界。
And God sets His grace on you because of His goodness, not because of your goodness.
神把他的恩典临在你的身上，是因为他的美善，不是因为你做得好。
If you pray 6 hours tomorrow,
如果明天你祷告6个小时，
God will not love you more.
神不会更爱你的。
If you have a rough day tomorrow,
如果你明天的生活不顺，
God will not love you less.
神也不会因此少爱你一点的。
It's so important we understand this.
我们非常重要，必须了解这一点。
And as those who have been forgiven and cleansed,
我们都是已经被饶恕，已经是洁净的人。
Now with all of our heart, we want to please the Lord.
我们要全心全意来讨神的喜悦。
We don't want to grieve Him.
我们不要使他忧伤。
We want to honor Him in all of our conduct.
我们所做的一切，为了要尊荣他。
Here's the problem with hypergrace.
这个极端的恩典的问题就是这样。
Hypergrace goes beyond what I just said.
极端的恩典超过刚才我所说的一切。
And hypergrace teachers believe this.
极端的恩典要我们相信。
The moment you are saved,
一旦你得救，
God forgives your past sins.
神赦免了你过去的罪。
I agree with that.
我认同这一点。
God forgives your present sins.
神也赦免你现在的罪。
I agree with that.
我也认同这一点。
But hypergrace teachers say this.
但是这些极端的恩典的人这样说。
God also forgives your future sins.
神也赦免了你未来的罪。
Did Jesus die for our sins?
耶稣有没有为我们的罪死呢？
Did he die for our sins past, present, future?
他为我们死是为了我们过去、现在和未来的罪死吗？
Absolutely.
绝对是。
But does he forgive our sins in advance?
但是他有没有预先来赦免我们的罪呢？
Of course not.
当然没有。
You say, why does it matter?
那么你说这有什么关系啊？
Let me explain why it matters.
让我解释有什么关系。
God does not convict me today of sins that I committed 20 years ago.
神会把我20年前犯的罪，提出来，让我知道我过去的错误。
He dealt with me about those already.
他已经处理了那些罪了。
I turned away from them already.
我已经离弃了那些罪。
I confessed them to God already.
我已经向神承认了那些罪。
I'm cleansed.
我被洁净了。
But let's say I did something wrong today.
假设今天我做错了一些事。
Let's say I was unkind to my brother.
我对我的弟兄没有这个好好对他。
The Holy Spirit will bring that to my attention.
圣灵会提醒我。
And I will go to my brother.
我会来到我弟兄面前。
Forgive me, I was unkind towards you.
对不起，请你原谅我，因为对你不好。
And I would go to God.
然后我自己来到神的面前。
Lord, wash me, cleanse me.
主啊，洗净我。
Not the washing and cleansing of salvation, I'm already saved.
不是洗净我，使我能够得救，因为我已经得救了。
But the washing and cleansing of being defiled.
而是把我污秽洗去。
The washing and cleansing that comes in a relationship.
使我能够重新和神有这个亲近的关系。
But hang on.
等一等。
If my future sins are already forgiven,
如果我未来的罪已经被赦免了，
then when I'm unkind to my brother,
当我对我的弟兄不好的时候，
if I think lustfully about my sister,
我对我的姐妹有这个淫乱的思想的时候，
if I'm dishonest with my employer's money,
如果我和我的这个雇主在钱方面有不老实的地方，
If those sins are already forgiven, then the Holy Spirit won't convict me about them.
如果这些罪都已经被赦免了，那么圣灵就不会再提醒我。
And I don't need to confess them to God because I'm already forgiven.
我也不需要再向神认罪了，因为我已经被赦免了。
And I'm just as holy when I sin as when I don't sin.
无论我犯罪不犯罪，我同样是圣洁的。
You see the danger that comes with that fundamental error.
你看到这个基本的错误所带来的这个危险吗？
Let me say this again.
让我再说一次。
The moment you are saved, you go in the column of those who are forgiven.
当你一得救的，那么你就进到这个被饶恕的这个范围里面。
But over the course of our lives in God, relationally, we need forgiveness.
但是在生活当中，我们和神的关系，我们需要得到饶恕。
Not the forgiveness of salvation, but the forgiveness of broken relationship or broken fellowship.
不是赦免我们以致我们可以得救，而是使那个破坏的关系能够重新被建立。
Hypergrace teachers say you don't need to confess your sin to God.
极端的恩典说你不需要向神来认罪。
You are already forgiven.
你已经被饶恕了。
Hypergrace teachers say the Holy Spirit will never convict a believer of sin.
极端的恩典的人说圣灵不会提醒信徒说他所犯的罪是什么。
God doesn't see your sins, so he won't convict you of your sins.
神不会看你所犯的罪，所以他不会要你认罪。
Of course, the whole New Testament is against this teaching.
当然，整个新约都反对这样的一种教导。
Throughout the New Testament, the authors are constantly correcting believers about sin.
整个新约都，我们都看到这些作者正在纠正信徒所犯的罪。
Why are they bringing correction about sin if God doesn't see our sin?
如果神不看我们的罪，为什么他要提醒我们，要改正我们的罪呢？
Why does the Word of God encourage believers to confess sin to God and one to another?
为什么在新约里面神的话要提醒我们彼此认罪，也要向神认罪呢？
Let me show you how dangerous this can be.
让我让你看看这到底有多危险。
Let's say that I lose the sensitivity in my hand.
假设我的手已经没有感觉。
The nerves are not functioning properly.
那个神经没有正常的运作。
I can put my hand on something burning hot.
我可以放在一些燃烧的很炽热的东西上面。
But I don't know it and my hand can burn.
但是我完全没有知觉，我的手就被烧伤了。
Sir, maybe you are at work and you're getting too friendly with your secretary.
那么先生，可能你对你的这个秘书非常的友善。
You're a married man, but you're getting too friendly with her.
你是一个已婚的人，但是呢，你和她的关系是过度的亲近了。
The Holy Spirit comes to convict you.
圣灵会来提醒你。
But that's not the Holy Spirit.
但那不是圣灵。
The Holy Spirit will never convict me of my sin.
圣灵不会使我认罪的。
God is coming to save you.
神来救你。
God is coming to save you from destroying your marriage.
神救你，使你的婚姻不是被破坏。
He wants you to feel that heat.
他要你感觉到那个热度。
But because of your theology, you say that's not the Holy Spirit.
因为你的神学，你说那个不是圣灵的提醒。
Plus, God loves me just the same, no matter how I'm living.
因为神看我，无论我怎么样生活，他都看我是一样的。
I'm already perfectly holy.
我是完全的圣洁。
God doesn't see my sin.
神没有看到我的罪。
God doesn't judge me based on my behavior.
神没有按我的行为来判断我。
You see how this deception can lead to real danger.
你可以看到这个欺骗怎么样使你进到非常危险的一个地步。
You might say to me,
你可能对我说，
But the whole witness of the Old Testament goes against this.
但是整个新约看起来好像的见证和这个不一样。
What do hypergrace teachers do with that?
这个极端的恩典教导什么呢？
Many of them almost discard it as irrelevant.
那么这个极端的恩典说他们都是不需要的。
You say, but the teachings of Jesus go against this.
但是你说耶稣的教导和这个不一样啊。
What do hypergrace teachers do?
这些极端恩典的人怎么做呢？
Many of them take it and discard it.
很多人就把它放在一边。
They say the words that Jesus spoke before the cross, that was for the Jews back then. They're not for today.
他说耶稣上十字架之前所说的那些话是给犹太人的，不是给我们现在的这些信徒。
This can lead to real danger and real deception.
这实在是非常大的一个欺骗，也是非常大的一个危险。
It also leads to great division.
也会带来极大的分裂。
Because those who encounter hyper grace and begin to follow it look at all of you and say, you are stuck under the law.
因为那些经历过这个所谓极端的恩典的人，他们会对你们说，哦，你们是在律法底下。
You are Pharisees and grace haters.
哦，你们是法利赛人，你们是恨恶恩典的人。
And it brings great division in the body.
就在基督的肢体里面带来极大的分裂。
In fact, some of the nastiest Christians I have ever met are those who say they have a new revelation of grace.
其实我遇到那些所谓得到新的启示关于这个恩典的人呢。
Let me just give you some quotes. Listen to what one hyper grace teacher says about the Old Testament.
听听其中一个教导这个极端的恩典的人讲到关于旧约的事情。
At the risk of sounding critical, it remains a sad reality that the Bible Society chose to combine the Old and New Testaments into one single book.
那么这些圣经学会啊，选择把新约和旧约放在一本书里面出版。
He said this single decision has caused widespread confusion within the ranks of believers throughout the world.
他说这使全世界的信徒造成极大的分裂。
Many of the writings in the Bible before the cross portray God to be a harsh, cruel being, set on destroying and punishing people if they dared to disobey the set of moral standards represented by the Ten Commandments and the other laws.
因为在旧约里面，圣经所描写的神是一位非常严酷、非常残暴的神。那么他把那些的犯了这个律法的人全部毁灭了。这个律法就是十诫。
This is shocking and dangerous.
这是为我们非常的震惊，也是非常危险的。
The Old Testament was the only Bible of Jesus and the apostles.
这个旧约圣经是使徒和耶稣所拥有的唯一的圣经。
But here a hyper grace teacher makes it into an alien book.
但是这些极端恩典的人把它成为一本非常这个好像从外星人来的一本书。
Here's another example.
另外一个例子。
Are you confused about the nature of God? Is he the God of judgment found in the Old Testament or the God of mercy and grace found in the New Testament?
可能你对神的性情感觉到混乱，他是一位旧约所讲的这个充满着判断的神，还是新约所讲的充满着恩典的神呢？
That quote I just gave you is from an American teacher. He goes around the world with his teaching.
那么刚才所讲的这些话是一个美国的教师，他在全世界所做的教导。
Let's look at some more.
我们再看其他的。
This is the words of Pastor Joseph Prince.
这是平约瑟所讲的一些话。
He's speaking about the words of Jesus.
他讲到耶稣的话。
For example, some things that Jesus said in the four Gospels were spoken before the cross, before he had died for our sins, and some were said after the cross, when he had already won our complete forgiveness and rightfully given us his righteousness. It is the latter that applies to us, believers under the new covenant today.
他说，举个例子，那么耶稣所说的一些东西呢？在四福音里面是他上十字架之前所说的，就是他为我们的罪而死之前说的。那么有一些是他为我们的罪，就是上了十字架之后所说的。那么这些话呢，使我们能够得到完全的赦免，使我们在他面前有一个合法的这个公义。这些话是对我们现今的信徒说的。
Is that clear?
清楚吗?
Our brother believes that the words that Jesus spoke before the cross do not apply to us as believers today.
平约瑟他相信耶稣在上十字架之前所说的话对我们今天的信徒是 不合用的。
Here's what another teacher says.
这里有另外一个教师这样说。
He's speaking about the Sermon on the Mount.
他讲到登山宝训。
He asked this question, is the Sermon on the Mount intended for the church?
他问了这个问题，登山宝训是给教会的吗？
Absolutely not.
当然不是。
It's intended for the self-righteous. It's a pre-salvation preach that exposes self-righteous pride and performance and reveals the need for God's righteousness as a gift through faith in order to see the kingdom and become children of God.
是给那些自义的，是给那些要靠自己的表现来赢取神的公义的人。这些人呢，他们要得到这些信心啊，以致他们能够进到神的国度，成为神的儿女。
Some of the most precious teaching in the Word is found on the lips of Jesus.
有一些最宝贵的这些教导是从神的啊耶稣的口中说出来的。
When Jesus gave the Great Commission, this is what he said.
当耶稣给我们大使命的时候，他这样说。
Go and make disciples of the nations.
到普天下使人做我的门徒。
Teaching them to observe everything I taught you.
我所教训你们的都教训他们遵守。
You cannot fully make a disciple unless you immerse that person in the teaching of Jesus.
除非你能够使一个人完全跟随耶稣的教导，不然的话，你就不是使人做门徒。
Jesus said, "We'll bear much fruit if we abide in Him, and His words abide in us."
耶稣说，如果我们常常亲近他，在他的里面，他的话也会在我们的里面，我们就能够多结果子。
Jesus said, "Heaven and earth will pass away, but His words will never pass away."
耶稣说天地都会废去，但是他的话一点一话都不会废去。
And yet we are being told that the teaching of Jesus in the Gospels was only for the Jews in his day and not for the church today.
我们啊，有人相信就是四福音是为犹太人而讲的，不是为教会而讲的。
Please skip down on the slides to where we talk about conviction of sin.
让我们就是看到这个关于定罪方面。
I want to give you an example of some of the teaching that is circulating through the body today dealing with these subjects.
那么我要让你看看在今天许多教会里面所传讲的关于这个定罪的这个课题。
Please understand.
你要了解。
I'm jealous for the grace of God.
我为神的恩典而嫉妒。
Every day of my life, I live in the favor of God.
每一天我的生活都活在神的恩典里面。
I never feel condemned.
我没有感觉那种定罪的感觉。
If I ever blow it, I know the Holy Spirit's convicting me out of the love of God.
那么如果我做错事情的时候，圣灵会提醒我，是因为神爱我。
Condemnation says, you're guilty, get away from me.
这个定罪是说你有罪了，那么你要远离我。
If you're a child of God, the Holy Spirit will never condemn you.
如果你是神的孩子，圣灵绝对不会定你的罪。
Condemnation says you're guilty, get away from me.
定罪是说，哦，你是有罪的，你要远离我。
Conviction says you've sinned, come back to me.
认罪是说，哦，你有罪了，你要回来向我承认你的罪。
Conviction is God's love drawing us back.
这个认罪呢，是神的爱吸引我们。
Listen to what hyper grace teachers say about conviction of sin.
听听这些这个极端恩典的人讲到怎么样关于认罪。
The Holy Spirit never convicts Christians of your sins. This is Pastor Prince.
这也是平约瑟讲的，他说圣灵不会叫信徒认罪。
He never comes to point out your faults.
他不会来指出你的错误。
It does not take a revelation from the Holy Spirit to see that you failed.
不需要圣灵的启示来让你看到你已经失败。
However, when you know that you failed, what you do need is for the Holy Spirit to convict you of your righteousness.
如果你已经失败的话，你只要圣灵来提醒你，在神的里面你是公义的。
Oh, I absolutely believe it's important for us to know that we have become the righteousness of God in Christ.
我绝对相信在耶稣的里面我们是公义的。
It's so important that we know that we're children of God, and therefore it's our nature not to sin.
很重要的，我们要知道我们是神的孩子，以致我们不会去犯罪。
But you better believe it's the love of God coming to make you feel uncomfortable when you do sin.
但是在你犯罪的时候，你必须相信是出于神的爱，使你觉得不舒服。
Sin is very deceptive.
罪是非常这个欺骗人的。
We can deceive ourselves and justify our sin.
我们会欺骗自己，以致我们说我们的罪是合法的。
Everybody watches pornography.
每个人都在看这些色情的东西了。
I'm not committing adultery.
啊，我不是在犯奸淫啊。
And I don't watch the really bad stuff.
我不是那些做坏事的东西。
The Holy Spirit in God's love comes to make us feel miserable about that.
那么圣灵会使我们觉得我们所做的是非常不好的。
And He draws us back to God so that we can be cleansed afresh.
他会吸引我们回到神的面前，以致我们能够被洁净。
Pastor Prince and other hyper-grace teachers say the Holy Spirit will never convict you of your sins.
平约瑟这位极端的恩典的教师，他说圣灵不会定你的罪的。
In fact, Pastor Prince gave this challenge.
其实平约瑟牧师给了这个挑战。
Show me one verse in the Bible where the Holy Spirit ever convicts believers of sin.
你要在圣经里面找到一节经文是讲到这个圣灵叫信徒认罪的吗？
And he points to John 16:8.
他让我们看约翰福音十六章第八节。
And there it says that the Holy Spirit convicts the world of sin.
这个经节是讲到圣灵使世界的人认罪。
But all you have to do is read the New Testament in Greek.
你所要做的只要读读新约的希腊文。
It's not a mystery at all.
那不是一个非常神秘的东西。
The same word used for convict is often used in the New Testament, speaking to believers.
那个认罪这个字啊，是永远是对那些信徒说的。
Jesus speaking to the churches in Asia Minor.
耶稣是对小亚细亚的信徒来讲话。
Revelation 3:19.
启示录第三章十九节。
Jesus says, "As many as I love, I rebuke and discipline."
我所爱的，我必会责备，并且管教。
That word rebuke is the very same word in Greek.
这个斥责呢也是同一个字在希腊文里面。
And then three verses later, it says, "This is what the Spirit is saying to the churches."
三节之后，他说这是圣灵对众教会所说的话。
That's just one example out of a number where that word is used speaking to New Testament believers.
那么这也是一个例子，让我们看到这个字认罪是指着新约的信徒而说的。
If the Holy Spirit never convicts us of our sins, why does Paul keep talking to believers about their sin and urging them to turn from that sin?
如果圣灵不会叫信徒认罪的话，保罗为什么不断的一再的对教会的人，就是信徒，叫他们要认罪呢？
According to hyper-grace teachers,
根据这些极端恩典的教师，
you are already completely holy.
你已经完全圣洁了。
Therefore, you cannot grow in holiness.
因此你不能够再圣洁多一点。
You are completely holy already.
你已经完全圣洁。
You start at perfection.
你已经完全了。
According to hyper-grace teachers,
根据这些极端恩典的人，
there's nothing you can do to break fellowship with God.
是没有任何东西能够破坏你跟神的关系的。
I have quote after quote about this from major leaders.
那么我跟不同的那些主要的领袖可以引用他们的话，一再的引用。
And I hear these teachings.
我听到他们这样教导。
And I ask myself.
我问自己说，
What do you do with this verse and this verse and this verse and this verse?
那么这一节怎么办？那一节怎么办呢？
2 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 1.
哥林多后书第七章第一节。
We've been given great promises from God.
神给我们极大的应许。
We are called sons and daughters of God.
我们称为神的儿女。
The Holy Spirit lives within us.
圣灵住在我们心中。
So what does Paul write in 2 Corinthians 7:1?
保罗在哥林多后书七章一节怎么说呢？
Therefore, because you have these promises,
因此你既有这等的应许。
He said, let us cleanse ourselves from everything that defiles body and spirit.
让我们洁净一切身体灵魂的污秽。
Perfecting holiness in the fear of God.
敬畏神，追求完整的圣洁。
In other words, we have been made holy by the Lord.
换句话说，我们已经被神完全的成为圣洁了。
Now we are called to live that holiness out.
神呼召我们要活出这个他已经做好的圣洁。
We have been set apart as holy.
我们已经被分别为圣，圣洁了。
Now we grow in holiness.
现在我们在圣洁上面要不断的追求成长。
What does Peter write in 1 Peter 1?
彼得在彼得前书第一章怎么说呢？
In light of the great salvation that you have,
我们既拥有这极大的救恩，
be holy in all your conduct.
在你一切所行的事上都当圣洁。
The Holy Spirit does not need to speak to me and say, be tall.
圣灵不需要对布朗博士说他要高一点。
I am tall.
他已经够高了。
He does not need to speak to me. Be male.
他只要对布朗博士说，你要更有男人气质。
I am male.
因为他是男人。
But he can say to me, live as a man.
他要告诉我说，活得像个男人。
We have been set apart as holy.
我们已经被分别为圣，是圣洁了。
We are called saints.
我们被称为圣徒。
And now God says to us, live it out.
神现在对我们说，活出来吧。
Be holy in all your conduct.
在你一切所行的事上都要圣洁。
First Thessalonians 4.
提摩太帖撒罗尼迦前书第四章。
Verse 3.
第三节说。
This is the will of God, even your sanctification.
这是神的旨意，是要你们分别为圣。
Learn how to live as holy people in this world.
在这世上学习做一个圣洁的种类。
I understand that we can have little differences on interpretation of verses.
我了解，对于圣经的解释，我们可以有一些不同的看法。
And each church can have its own emphasis and calling.
每一个教会可以有他自己所强调的，还有他的呼召。
But there are some things that are terribly dangerous.
但是有些事情是非常危险的。
Now please hear me.
听清楚。
All the time I meet people who have been wonderfully blessed by the message of hyper grace.
每一次当我遇到那些被极端的这个恩典的教导所祝福很大的人呢？
It's not because the whole message is true.
不是因为他们所相信的是完全对的。
It is because when they heard it for the first time, they understood grace.
因为是他们第一次听到这样的教导，他们开始了解什么叫做恩典。
They got a revelation of the love of God.
他们对神的爱有一个启示。
They got a revelation of the fact that Jesus paid it all.
他们知道耶稣已经付出了一切的代价。
They now understood I've been made holy and righteous in God.
他们知道在神的面前他们是圣洁的，是公义的。
And the Father loves me because of his goodness.
是因为出于神的美善。
And even on a really bad day, I'm still his child.
就算我在最坏的一天，我还是他的孩子。
But all the time, I hear from people and their friends who have been destroyed by the message of hyper grace.
但是每一次我都听到，因为这个极端的恩典，许多人因此做坏了事情。
We must be jealous for the truth of grace.
我们对这个恩典的真理应该有这个极度的心。
We must understand where we stand in the Lord, forgiven by His grace.
我们要知道，在神的面前，我们已经因他的恩典完全被饶恕。
And then, as those forgiven and accepted, we live with all of our might to please God.
正因为有这个恩典跟饶恕，我们要更勇敢地来为神站立。
We find that place of rest, and then we run, run, run.
我们找到了这个安息的地方，以致我们可以不断地得力去向前跑。
There are hyper grace teachers who say you need to get rid of this mentality to please God. You are already fully pleasing to God.
极端恩典的教导说，你不需要去讨神的喜悦，因为你已经得到神的喜悦了。
I was reading a book one time.
有一次我读一本书。
And the beginning of the book, it said this.
在书的开始这样说。
And I bring things to a close.
那么我就要做一个结束。
The pastor said this.
这个牧师这样说。
My church has been on a great journey.
我的教会开始了一个极大的旅程。
We have been delivered from legalism.
我们已经从这个律法主义被解放出来。
We have discovered the grace of God.
我们开始了解神的恩典。
And we are now walking in newfound freedom.
我们已经在一种新的自由里面。
It sounded good.
听起来非常好。
There was only one problem.
但是有一个问题。
It was a homosexual pastor.
这是一个同性恋的牧师。
It was an LGBT church.
是一间同志运动的教会。
And I see that same dangerous tendency.
我看到同样的危险。
Praise God.
赞美神。
We're not under the law anymore.
我们不在律法里面了。
Praise God, we're free.
赞美神，我们是自由的了。
Ah, we're now free to do the law of God.
Ah, 我们现在可以自由地做神的律法。
We're now free to keep the commandments.
我们可以自由地来守诫命。
Now it's our nature not to commit adultery.
现在是我们的这个本性不会犯奸淫。
Now it's our nature to love God and our neighbor.
现在我们可以爱我们的邻舍了，是我们的本性。
Now it's our nature to do good to others.
我们可以去向人传福音。
We've been set free from the law.
我们已经从律法里面得到解放。
And brought into the glorious call of holiness.
进到这个荣耀的这个圣洁里面。
Many misunderstand this.
很多人误解了这个。
And I encourage you.
我鼓励你。
Watch the fruit of the message of grace.
要看这个恩典的信息的这个果子。
The true message of grace will lead you into greater devotion to Jesus.
真正的恩典的信息使你更委身于耶稣基督。
The true message of grace will deepen your burden to reach out to the lost.
真正的恩典的信息会把你的重担放下，让你可以自由地出去传福音。
The true message of grace will raise your standards of holiness, not lower them.
真正的恩典的信息是把你这个圣洁的标准提高，而不是使它低落的。
If one of your friends says to you,
如果你的朋友对你说
，Man, I've got a great revelation of grace now.
哇，现在我得到一个极大的关于恩典的启示。
I'm not in one of those legalistic churches anymore.
我不再教那个律法的教会里面了。
I'm free.
我是自由的了。
And you see now their standards of holiness are dropping.
你就会看到他的这个圣洁的标准不断的低落。
You see that they're not serious for God in prayer anymore.
他不再对神认真，不再祷告。
You see that they're much more caught up with this world than winning the lost.
他们在这个世界里面打滚，而不再去传福音。
They didn't get a revelation of God's grace.
他们没有得到神的恩典的启示。
They got deceived by hyper grace.
他们接受的是这个极端的恩典。
Read 1 Peter when you get a chance.
如果有机会，你读彼得前书。
It's a book of holiness.
是一本关于圣洁的书。
It's a book of discipline.
是关于这个纪律的书。
It's a book that calls us to prayer.
是使我们去祷告的书。
Calls us to humility. Calls us to service.
让我们谦卑，让我们能够去服侍的书。
And then he gets to verse 12.
你来到十二节的时候。
And this is what he says.
彼得这样说。
This is how he summarizes the book.
这是他怎么样总结这本书。
This is the true grace of God.
这是神真正的恩典。
Isn't that interesting?
这不是很有趣吗？
A book of exhortation.
一本劝勉的书。
A book of holiness.
一本圣洁的书。
And he says, this is the true grace of God.
证明这恩是神的真恩。
There are many, many verses we haven't been able to touch.
有很多很多的经文，我们今天没有办法去看。
There are some extremes in hyper grace that have gotten very, very dangerous.
这个极端的恩典是非常危险的。
Some say because Jesus paid it all on the cross, there's nothing you can possibly do.
有些说，因为耶稣基督已经完全在十字架上付出了一切的代价，你什么都不能做了。
You can't even add your faith to it. That would be a work.
你只能凭信心去接受，你不需要再做什么。
And there's some extreme hyper grace teachers that say everyone, the entire world, will eventually be saved because Jesus paid it all.
这些极端的恩典说，有一个时候呢，全世界都会得救，因为耶稣为他们每一个付上了代价。
One teacher said even the devil will get saved. That's how great God's grace is.
有一个教师甚至说连这个撒旦也会得救，这就是神的恩典。
Always watch where the teaching goes.
要看看这些教导会引导你到什么地步。
And if it produces greater holiness,
如果能够产生出圣洁，
greater devotion to Jesus,
对耶稣更大的委身，
greater hunger for the word,
对话语更大的渴慕，
greater love for the body,
对基督的肢体更大的爱，
greater love for the lost,
对世上的灵魂更大的爱，
then rejoice.
那么你就喜乐吧。
If it produces something else,
因为产生出另外的果子。
Be on guard. It's dangerous.
啊，这些极端的恩典是非常危险的。
Let's pray.
让我们祷告。
Father, I ask you.
天父，求你。
I ask you to speak to each of us.
对我们每一个人说话。
With clarity.
清楚地说话。
I ask you to open the eyes of our understanding.
求你开我们的眼睛，以致我们能够了解。
Lord, many of us fail to understand your grace.
我们很多人不了解你的恩典。
And we're working so hard to get your favor.
我们很努力的工作，要得到你的恩典。
May there be a fresh revelation of your grace and goodness.
让你的美善，你的恩典对我们有一个新的启示。
Others have fallen into hyper grace.
有些已经进到这个极端的恩典里面。
We pray for our brothers and sisters.
我们为我们的弟兄姐妹祷
告。We pray for those whose words we have quoted.
我们说刚才所引用的那些话，我们祷告。
We ask you for the fullness of your blessing on them.
求你完全的祝福临在他们身上。
We ask you, Lord, for an even greater outpouring of grace and truth.
让我们对恩典、对真理有一个更大的了解。
We ask for the Church of Singapore.
求你使新加坡的教会
Give us ears to hear what your spirit is saying.
听到你圣灵所说的话。
We ask it in Jesus' name.
奉耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen. Dr. Michael Brown has written a book called Hyper Grace.
布朗博士写了一本书叫做《极端的恩典》。
I've studied it carefully.
我很小心地读。
If you have been to this church for many years,
如果你来这个教会已经很多年了，
and if you have heard the way I preach,
你听我所讲的道，
you will realize that I've never attacked anybody.
你发现我从来不攻击任何人。
In fact,
事实上，
I know of many people that I don't invite to my platform because I have some issue concerning some of the teachings.
我认识很多人，我没有邀请他们到教会来讲道，是因为我发觉他们的教导里面有一些我是不能够认同。
Because it's my job to guard the truth.
因为我的工作就是要保护真理。
There are some people with reputable ministry that has a very correct teaching.
有些他们的服事的这个很著名，他们的教导也很好。
But sometimes the way the ministry takes place, and the way it's done, somehow I don't feel comfortable. It's a little bit too flashy or too dramatic.
但是他们在服事的时候呢，那个做法，我觉得不大舒服，因为是太过出于肉体了。
And I just don't sense that there's the right spirit.
我没有感觉到一个正确的精神在那边。
And quietly, I will not include them in the things I do.
慢慢的，我只是默默的，没有把他们包括在我所做的工作里
面。But I've never said anything negative about them.
但是我从来没有说一些负面的话。
Because there is a variety of understanding in many issues with regard to the Christian life.
对于基督徒的生活，我们很多课题我们有不同的了解。
There are some who insist that when you're baptized, you've got to be immersed.
有些说你浸礼的时候必须要浸在水里面。
There are some who suggest that sprinkling is good enough because it's what the essence of baptism means.
有些说洒水就够了，因为这正是这个浸礼的意义。
There are some who believe that we got to pray in tongues because we learn to pray in the Spirit. That's what our church believe in.
有些说你必须用方言来祷告，因为这是灵里面的祷告，这是我们教会所相信的。
There are other believers who are not come other ministers who do not believe in that.
但是有些人并不这样子相信。
And we have never used this to be a point of division.
我们不会用这个来作为一个分别的这种借口。
Some of my best friends are non-charismatic pastors.
有些我最好的牧师，他们不是灵恩的教师。
And we minister together in Love Singapore.
我们在爱新加坡里面一起服事。
For years, I have put aside some of this peripheral issue because on this side of heaven, we have no perfect knowledge.
因为这么多年我们把这些放在外围，因为这个没有一个绝对的这个认识。
And we are growing in the knowledge of God more and more.And in His truth.
我们对神对真理的认识越来越多。
So for 38 years of my ministry, I never attack or speak negatively about any ministry.
所以服事了38年，我从来没有攻击任何的服事。
But in the recent years and especially months,
在最近几年，特别是最近几个月，
as I began to study the teaching of this hyper grace,
当我开始去认识这个超级恩典的教导的时候
，that basically say that God doesn't convict Christian of sin，
基本上说神不会使基督徒认罪的。
There is no need for confession，
不需要向神认罪。
In fact, otherwise you are under the law，
不然你就是在律法之下。
It is a spirit of condemnation，
这是一个定罪的精神。
And as a result of that kind of understanding，
结果这样的一种理解的话呢，
we dismiss the whole Old Testament，
我们把整本旧约都不要了。
We dismiss all that Jesus has said before he died，
我们把耶稣在死之前所说的一切都放下了。
You dismiss the Sermon on the Mount and Lord's Prayer is not even to be used，
把登山宝训也放下了，甚至主导文也不可以用。
Because in the Lord's Prayer it says forgive my sin as I forgive the sin of others，
因为主导文说赦免我们的罪像我们赦免人的罪一样。
And this hyper grace preacher say this is no longer to be prayed in the New Testament after the cross，
这个极端恩典的教师说在十字架以后这些不应该这样祷告了。
And then it says that if you just need to, if you feel pressured to serve the Lord, then you're under condemnation, you're under the law.
那么他们也说，如果你被感动去要服侍主的话，那么你也是在恩典之下。
But the Bible says that the apostle Paul feels oppressed from all sides and feels strapped in and knocked down, but not knocked out, and he still rise up.
是在律法之下。那么保罗其实他感觉到四面受敌，好像被困住一样。
The Bible tells us to endure suffering，
圣经教我们要忍受苦难。
To fight the good fight，
要为那美好的仗打那美好的仗。
To buffet our bodies so that we don't please our own desires，
要克制己身，以致我们不会为那些情欲的事情。
And in our church we train our people to deny themselves and to follow the Lord，
在我们教会我们要舍己，要跟随基督。
And in a hyper grace teaching that will be a spirit of condemnation，
在超级恩典的这个教导下这就是定罪的一种做法。
That will be legalism，
这就是律法主义。
And as a result of that，
结果呢，
we see Christians beginning to be deceived living in sin and yet saying thatI have freedom in Christ。
结果我们看到基督徒在活在罪里面，却说我在基督里面是自由的。
And I've asked Dr. since Dr. Michael Brown is preaching our church, I said address some of the key issues today。
那么既然布朗博士在我们教会讲到，我就邀请他讲一些主要的这些要点。
The last thing we want to do is to undermine the immensity of God's grace。
最后我们要知道神的这个恩典的伟大。
And that God is so gracious, He let us start again and again to walk right with Him.
神这么充满着恩典，以致他让我们可以不断的重新再来。
If some of you recall, I preached a message that the grace that caused us to serve God beyond our ability.
你记得的话，我曾经讲过一篇道，就是说神的恩典使我们能够超越我们的能力来服侍神。
Grace is being able to pay the price. Even everything within us tell us, give up. It's too tiring. It's too demanding. The onslaught of the evil one is too hard. But you say, God, I'm gonna just bite the bullet, believe you for grace, and persevere until the victory is won. That's called fighting the good fight.
即使我们里面非常的挣扎，非常的困难，使我们简直要放弃了， 但是神的恩典叫我们能够继续站起来，来为神打那美好的仗。
And hyper grace will rob you of that understanding and deprive you of exploring the immensity of God's grace that can cause you to do exceeding abundantly what you could even think or ask.
极端的恩典的人使我们不能够了解神这种超越性的恩典。
I hope you understand. Just about 2-3 weeks ago, I wrote in my thought of the week a very important thought. I know some of you don't even read it. I sometimes wonder why am I writing this.
其实我在我这个每周的感言里面啊，写了几点。
You know, I heard a wonderful message when I was in East Timor.
在东帝汶，我有一个非常好的这个信息。
Pastor Daniel Fu made a statement that really struck me, and I totally agree.
Daniel Fu 牧师啊，讲了一句话，使我非常的感动，我完全同意。
He said, Ephesians chapter 3, the last verse says that God is able to do exceeding abundantly.Beyond three things above all that you can think or ask.
以弗所书第三章最后讲到，神能够做啊超过我们所想所求的。
In other words, if you think that God can, you can only run to this far.
如果你想神使我们跑到这么远而已。
You cannot imagine you can go further than that.
你不能够想象你能够再跑远一点。
All your strength has failed.
你的力量已经用尽了。
You cannot even imagine that something like that can be done.
你不能够想象这样的事情能够发生。
God says,
神说
He is able,
他能够
to do exceeding,
做超过你所想。
Abundant,
所求的
beyond what you ask or think,
超过你所想所求的。
In other words, you say, "God, no more strength. I'm going to die." God says, "And you can do way beyond, three times more."
你想你能够做到这里了，但是神的恩典使你能够做三步。
And how can you do that?
你怎么能够做到这一
点呢？ If you read that preceding verses,
如果你读前面一节的经文
，Paul made a prayer.
保罗做了一个祷告
that God will open the eyes of the saints,
神能够开信徒的眼睛
that together with all the saints, we may understand the height, the depth, the length, and the breadth, and to know the love of God.
我们可以和众圣徒一同明白神爱的长阔高深
This love of God is what caused us to dare to go beyond.
这个神的爱使我们能够敢敢的超越这一切。
And this love of God is the grace of God that surpasses understanding.
这个神的爱就是超越一切我们所能够想象的这个神的恩典。
That a heroin shooting hippie rock band drummer who curses God would be set free instantly.
是这位啊，过去怎么样打海洛因，怎么样咒诅神的人，马上被释放。
And it's only in that grace that we dare to jump the, and believe God for the impossible.
就是因为有这个恩典，以致我们可以跳，可以做那个不可能的事。
But hyper grace say, if you feel wow pressured and you have to push through, well, you're using the flesh.
但是极端的恩典的人说，哇，你要努力才能够做到的，那就是肉体了。
You're working under condemnation.
你是被定罪的了。
I know I can go on, and you're never going to go home.
Okay, 再说下去你就不用回家了。
Actually, Dr. Brown is really gracious because he got so much, he got a whole book on that, and that's all he shared with us, and that's great.
不然恩典实在很带我们，他整本书了，写了整本书，但是他和我们分享。
I've come to understand that this grace, which unfortunately is being exported from Singapore in a great way, is going to destroy many lives.
很不幸的，这个极端的恩典，既然从新加坡啊出口，会摧毁很多人的生命。
And this church we're talking about, and you know what I'm talking about, went to East Timor and said, "Hey, we want to adopt a certain district like all the churches do, but they cannot raise a team to go there."
这间教会我知道，你知道是哪一间教会？他 曾经答应我们说要到这个东帝汶和我们一起服事，但是他居然没有办法兴起一堆人去做。
It is because that kind of teaching does not produce extreme disciple for Jesus Christ. What is needed to bring the grace of God around the world and to see its power manifested?
这种极端的恩典没有办法兴起耶稣基督极限的门徒，来把神的恩典带到世界去。
And today God wants us.To say, I want to actually, I found that this is not really high. I mean, apology. I don't see this to be even hypergrace. I think it is so much below what the grace of God is. It is diminishing the extent of God's grace.
我不会把它当成一个非常超越的恩典，它其实是完全让我们对神的恩典有一个误解。
A grace that allows us to sin and we don't feel like we are hurting and grieving the Lord is not a grace at all.
如果恩典使我们犯罪而没有让我们去觉得对不起神的话，这根本不是恩典。
But today our church believes in grace upon grace. Amen.
今天我们教会相信是恩上加恩。Amen.
The grace that not only save us and make us the sons and the daughters of God.
这个恩典不只是拯救我们，使我们成为神的儿女。
But the grace that we daily appropriate and say, Lord, I don't want to talk about holiness. I want to live in holiness.
而是这个恩典使我们每天对神说，主啊，我要活得圣洁。
And we say, thank you for your grace.
谢谢你的恩典。
That if we deviate from your path, the Holy Spirit will scream at us.
如果我们偏离了你的道路，圣灵会提醒我们，会向我们呼喊。
Because sin destroys us.
因为罪会摧毁我们。
It destroys our family.
摧毁我们的家庭。
It destroys our spirit. That's what the Bible says.
摧毁我们的灵，这是圣经说的。
It defiles our body and spirit.
它会污染我们的身体、
God、
灵魂。
God be gracious to me.
主啊，对我施恩啊。
Don't let me go too far.
不要让我超越你。
Lord, we can't hear you very well sometimes because we are men of the flesh sometimes.
因为我们是属肉体的，有时我们听不清楚。
But Lord, give me grace upon grace.
主啊，让恩典恩典不断的引导我。
And Lord, if I don't hear you clearly, I'm deceived by my sin. Please scream at me.
主啊，如果我听不到你说的，而在罪里面沉沦的话，求你向我呼喊。
Please stop me.
停止我。
In fact, do something drastic so that I cannot go on.
做一些非常突出的事情，以致我不能继续下去。
That's the grace of God to live in holiness.
这就是神的恩典，使我们活在圣洁。
But Lord, thank you for the saving grace.
主啊，谢谢你拯救的恩典。
Thank you for the grace that makes me holy.
谢谢你的恩典，使我圣洁。
Now I can, my life is different.
现在我的生命不一样了。
My relationship with my wife is restored since I gave up pornography because only my wife can satisfy me.
自从我放下黄色的刊物，我和我太太的关系好了。
Lord, I'm overwhelmed by your grace.
主啊，我被你的恩典所充满。
Now, God,
主啊，现在
I want to go to the ends of the world to preach the gospel.
我要到世界的尽头传福音。
I want to go to Nepal when there's an earthquake, and if I got a chance to share the gospel, I'm going to go.
尼泊尔有地震，我要去，有机会我就讲。
And any place in the world, I will go if you send me.
如果任何地方你差派我，我就去。
But I know I cannot make it, that I'm weak.
我知道我做不到，因为我是软弱的。
I'm a man with the feet of clay.
我是用泥土造的人。
But since I've experienced your saving grace,
因为我经历了你拯救的恩典。
And since you have, I've seen your grace in making me holy.
因为你的恩典使我能够圣洁。
Now God, if you send me over here where I would die for your faith, God, I trust your grace to be sufficient for what you've called me to do.
主啊，你派我来这边，就算是我相信你的恩典足够让我做你所要做的事。
Even if I'm trembling and fearing, but Lord, I will walk because I know that your grace is sufficient.
虽然我恐惧战惊，我知道你的恩典够的话，我会继续走下去。
And the day that I'm going to be martyred for my faith, I believe at that moment you will give me the grace to bear it.
假设有一天我要为主来殉道的话，我也相信你会给我这个殉道的恩典。
It is a grace to do exceeding abundantly beyond what we can ask or think.
是 恩典使我们能够做超过我们所想所求的。
So don't let the hyper grace through our teaching rob you of that full immensity of God's grace.
不要让这个极端的恩典偷取了神这个丰盛的恩典。
And today, God wants to extend that grace to you.
今天神要把这个恩典临到你身上。
Some of you have never given your life to Jesus Christ, and the first time you're here, a friend brought you, or you have never made that decision in spite of coming for a little while.
有些人没有把你的生命献给主，是你的朋友邀请你，所以今天你来到这里。
And some of you didn't make that decision because you thought, no, let me get better. Let me kind of straighten out my life before I give my life to the Lord.
有些人没有做这个决定，他是说，哦，让我做得更好一点的时候，我才把生命献给主吧。
And the Lord said, if you can straighten up your life by yourself, you don't need God.
主说，如果你能够做得更好，你就不需要神了。
When do you need to see a doctor? Is it when you're well or when you're sick?
什么时候你需要看医生呢？是你生病的时候，还是你健康的时候呢？
And the word of God's grace is if today you are convicted and say, I want to thank God for what he had done on the cross. I want to receive him into my life. I want to be a child of God. Today, instantly, right now, your sins are forgiven and you are a new creation.
神的恩典临到你的身上。如果你说我承认我的罪，我接受耶稣基督在十字架上面所成就的一切，今天你就可以成为神的儿女。
When the thief died on the cross and said to Jesus, "Remember me today in paradise," and Jesus said, "Today you will be with me."
当十字架上那个强盗对主说，主啊，求你纪念我。
So today, if you have never given your life to Jesus,
如果今天你从来没有把生命献给主
，you cannot help yourself.
你不能够控制自己。
The Lord said, "You just simply come by faith."
主说你只要凭信心出来。
In fact, the Lord says that the faith as a mustard seed is all it takes for you to be saved.
事实上，主说只要像芥菜种那么小的信心，你就可以得救了。
Because what's important is not the extent of your faith, but the reliability and the greatness on the God who loved you and died for you.
因为重要的不是你信心的大小，而是这位神爱你。
In a minute, we're going to pray.
接下来我们要祷告。
And I want to lead you in a prayer for those who have never accepted Jesus Christ as Savior.
我要为那些还没有从来没有接受过主的人祷告。
And if you have never done that, God says the doors to heaven is open right now.
如果你从来没有这样做，神说现在天上的门已经敞开了。
The gate of salvation is open.
救恩的大门已经敞开了。
This is the day of salvation.
现在就是得救的日子。
Today you can be born again.
今天你就可以重生。
Today you can be a child of God.
今天你就可以成为神的儿女。
So as I lead you in that prayer,
当我带领你做这个祷告的时候，
I want you to repeat after me.
我要你跟着我祷告。
If you have never given your life to Jesus,
如果你从来没有把生命献给主，
and if you mean in your heart, today you'll be saved.
如果你是从心里说的，
let's bow our head and close our eyes, everybody.
让我们低头祷告。
No one moving around.
没有人移动。
Will you just bow your head and close your eyes?
低头闭上你的眼睛。
I know in a crowd like that,
我知道在这么大的群众里面。
How can we preach about grace without extending an invitation for somebody you who can't give your life to Jesus today?
我们讲到恩典，但是我们怎么不能够发出这个邀请来邀请人来领受这个恩典？
In fact, I believe that grace is so important. That's why the devil wants to distort it and to put in error so that we will miss it.
事实上，罪这个恩典是这么重要，以致这个撒旦要放一些错误在当中，
使你这个错过。So if you never invited Jesus into your life,
如果你从来没有邀请耶稣进你的生命
，today you can do it right now.
现在你就可以这样做。
Over the auditorium, every head bow, every eye closed, please.
在这里，每个人低下头，闭上眼睛。
I lead you in that prayer.
我要带领你做祷告了。
I first lead you in English, and then I'll lead you in Mandarin. 我先用英语带领那些要接受主的，然后我再用中文，我说一句，你说一句。First, I use English, and those who are English speaking, if you want to receive Jesus Christ, pray this prayer with me. And all the Christians, could you join in so that those who are praying it for the first time sense that they are part of God's family? Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven,
Dear Father,
thank you for this message of grace.
Thank you for this message of grace.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That I do not have to work my way to heaven.
That I do not have to work my way to heaven.
That I do not have to be good enough for heaven.
That I do not have to be good enough for heaven.
But that you love me.
But that you love me.
And came and died for me on the cross.
And came and died for me on the cross.
The one who knew no sin.
The one who knew no sin.
To become sin on my behalf.
To become sin on my behalf.
So that I may have God's righteousness.
So that I may have God's righteousness.
Dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
Today I open my life.
Today I open my life.
And my heart.
And my heart.
I invite you to come into my life.
I invite you to come into my life.
I surrender my life to you.
I surrender my life to you.
Please forgive my sins.
Please forgive my sins.
Cleanse my heart.
Cleanse my heart.
Change me from the inside.
Change me from the inside.
As of this day, Lord.
As of this day, Lord.
I give you my life.
I give you my life.
Help me.
Help me.
To love you.
To love you.
And obey you.
And obey you.
And walk with you.
And walk with you.
All the rest of my life.
All the rest of my life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm going to lead it in Chinese now. 那些中文你今天要接受主的神的恩典就是这么伟大你现在跟我做这个祷告我说一句你说一句亲爱的天父
亲爱的天父
谢谢你的爱
谢谢你的爱
谢谢你的恩典
谢谢你的恩典
你为着我们的罪
你为着我们的罪
死在十字架上
死在十字架上
我们不需要
我们不需要
靠着我们的行为
靠着我们的行为
靠着我们的公义
靠着我们的公义
来蒙你的喜悦
来蒙你的喜悦
谢谢你
谢谢你
你那无罪的
你那无罪的
成为罪
成为罪
代替我
代替我
死在十字架上
死在十字架上
使到我能够
使到我能够
得着你的公义
得着你的公义
亲爱的主耶稣基督
亲爱的主耶稣基督
今天我求你赦免我的罪
今天我求你赦免我的罪
洁净我的心
洁净我的心
进入我的生命
进入我的生命
我把生命交托给你
我把生命交托给你
从今以后
从今以后
我的生命是属于你的
我的生命是属于你的
求你引导我
求你引导我
带领我
带领我
一生一世
一生一世
跟随你
跟随你
相信你
相信你
全心的爱你
全心的爱你
主谢谢你
主谢谢你
I want every head to be bowed, every eye closed.
现在每个人低下头，闭下眼
睛。I want to pray a prayer for those who pray that prayer for the first time in your life, asking Jesus to forgive you, receiving God's grace.
我为那些刚才第一次做这个祷告的人啊，祷告祝福。
I want to see who you are.
我要看到你是谁。
I know a crowd like that. There's somebody you who have opened your heart to Jesus.
我知道在当中一定有人，你开你的心接受耶稣。
I'm going to count to three.
我要算三。
I'll count one, two, and three.
我数到一二三。
And the minute I count to three,
当我数到三的时候。
I want you to raise your hand.
我要你举起手来。
Wherever you are,
不论你在哪里。
And don't put it down again.
然后不要放下。
You do not need to lift up your head.
你不需要抬起头。
You don't need to open up your eyes.
你不需要张开眼睛。
With your head bowed, with your eyes closed.
你仍然低下头，闭上眼睛。
Raise your hand.
举起你的手。
In so doing, you are saying to me.
这样说，你是对我说。
Pastor Kong, pray for me.
邝牧师为我祷告。
For the first time in my life.
我生命中第一次。
I understand what grace is.
我了解什么叫做恩典。
I mean the prayer that I just prayed.
刚才我的祷告是从心里而发的。
Please pray a blessing for me.
请你为我祝福。
I'll be delighted to bless you.
我很高兴为你祝福。
No one looking around.
没有人周围
观看。I'm going to count right now.
现在我要开始数了。
One, two, three. Raise your hand.
举手。
Raise it up high.
举你的手，高高举起。
Raise it up high. Over the place. Over the place. Somebody you who say, I prayed that prayer to receive Christ.
有人说我做了祷告，
Keep your hands up.
继续举手。
Pray for you.
继续祷告。
We can see you now.
我看到你，我要为你祷告。
Dear Father in heaven,
亲爱的天父
，Thank you,
谢谢
for these who have opened their hearts,
那些已经开敞开的心
for the first time in their life,
他们生命中第一次
in the name of Jesus,
奉耶稣基督的名
，I declare,
我宣告
that your sins are forgiven because of your faith,
你因为信心的缘故，你的罪已经赦免了。
I declare,
我宣告
that Jesus comes into your life,
耶稣进到你的生命
，cleanse you from your sin.
洁净你的罪
and make you a child of God,
使你成为神的儿女
and the Lord is with you,
主与你同在。
And he will never leave you or forsake you.
他不会离弃你，也不会抛下你。
In the name of Jesus.
奉耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
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 Come on, let's stand up.
让我们站
起来。Come on, give God a big round of applause. This is what I want to do.
接下来我要做的是。
Because of time, I don't want to stretch it, but this is what I want to do.
我要做的是。
There were a number of you who raised your hand just now.
刚才很多人举手。
And in a crowd like that, there will always be some who don't feel comfortable, but you want to receive Christ, but you don't quite raise up your hand. It doesn't matter. This is what I want you to do.
如果刚才你觉得不舒服，没有举手的话，现在我要你这样做。
On the count of three, wherever you are, I want you to take your belongings and come forward here to your right. That means on my left, to right here, where Pastor Evelyn Chok is. Pastor Evelyn Chok, just raise your hand. All right, and you just stand in front of her because I'm going to have everybody to pray a prayer for you. And when I count to three, just take your belongings. If a friend brought you, I'd be happy to do that. So, okay, and we want to welcome you. But before we do that,
我们在做之前呢,
I want to give an invitation
我要再做一个邀请,
for some of you who say, today I want a fuller experience of the grace of God.
你说我要更大的来经历神的恩典。
And you say, I'm struggling with something in my life.
你说我生命里头有一些挣扎。
It could be a sin in my life.
可能是我生命里有的罪。
It could be something in the ministry, and I'm so discouraged. And I want God to impart a special grace for me to do exceeding abundantly beyond what we can think or ask.
可能是你的服事，你非常的挣扎，你需要神给你的特别的恩典，以致你能够做超过你所想所求的。
I want to believe God for grace that caused me to do things I rather not do or I feel pressured into doing, but I will do that because of God's grace. And you need that special endowment of grace. You come right here to your left, and I want to pray for you before the service is over.
你啊，做一些事情你不想做，但是你相信神的恩典能够。是你做得到，那么你就出来，神特别的恩典会临到你的身上。
On the count of three, you come.
我数三声，你就
出来。We welcome you. One, two, three. Come on, let's welcome those who raise your hand just now. Come forward right now, and bring a friend here. If you have just accepted the Lord, accepted God's grace, you come here. 你刚刚领受到神的恩典，你来到神的面前。今天是得救的日子，神的恩典能够无条件的接受你，因为他为你死在十字架上。你赶快来。The grace of God will accept you unconditionally. His grace is unconditional because his love is unconditional. You don't have to perform. You don't have to prove yourself to be a child of God. God has done it on your behalf. So if you are accepting the Lord for the first time, come over here, just about in front of me and pack in as much as you can. This is the day of salvation. 你来吧，快点来，今天是得救的日子，今天是神给你命定的日子。But if those of you who want to say, I need a special grace today, I just acknowledge I need His grace. Instead of feeling hard-pressed, instead of feeling condemned, you just run to the throne of grace. You understand that? And say, I want the grace to victorious life. I want the grace to be able to break free from the sin. I want the grace to be able to find strength to go through what God wants me to do in spite of all the difficulties and the struggle. Because this is a grace, this is the kind of grace that the Bible is talking about. I want to pray for these who are accepting the Lord. 我要为着这些第一次接受主的祷告。今天是你得救的日子。Today is the day of salvation. Just remember, you are fully forgiven not because you made the mark.But because God died in your place. That's the wonderful message of the gospel. And so today, don't let the devil sow seeds of doubt and say, maybe my faith is not good enough. Maybe I'm not good enough. The Lord says, I know you're not good enough. But I have taken your place on the cross. So you came out here. I want the whole church to pray for you. Because the Bible says, if you accept Christ, you are born again. You're born again in the family of God. And that means it doesn't matter how old or how young you are.You are a little baby in Jesus. 你要走出来是因为当你接受主的时候神说你重生得救。重生就是说你是一个属灵的孩子。不论你是多年长或者年幼你是神的孩子。A baby needs a family to love you. So that's why I want the whole family to pray for you. 一个属灵的婴孩需要一个属灵的家来伴着你来栽培你使到你能够好好的成长。所以我叫整个教会为你祷告祷告之后跟着一位牧师在你的右边走到后面我们有些资料要给你我们要 帮助你在你的灵命里面成长。 After the prayer, turn to your right and go with the pastor to a little room out there. We want to take down your particulars, but we want to give you some material that will help you to be able to take those first baby step in this newfound life that God has given to you. Understand that? Church, let's stretch our hand and pray for them. 天父，我们谢谢你看到这些来到你的面前。主，你说当天使天君看到一个罪人悔改得救，整个天上的天使都在欢呼。主，谢谢你，你看到这么多人在这里把生命交托给你。我奉主耶稣基督的名宣告你的罪被赦免，但是主，让他们在生命里面经历到你的恩典，经历到你的能力，经历到你的平安，在他们的事业、学业、家庭、他们的健康、他们的人际关系，都看到主你的改变。 Father, we thank you, Lord, that we don't have to work for our salvation, that is by grace that we are saved. We thank you that they have come in simple faith, just as they are, to give their life to you. Lord, I declare that the grace will grow and grow and grow in their life, so that their life will be radically changed, that their life will live in such a way that they would experience your love, your presence, your intimacy, and your peace all the days of their life, in their own workplace, in their own school, in their own home, in every relationship they have. We commit them to you. We stand with them. We welcome them into the family of God in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's welcome them as they go. Will you please turn to the right and go? And these people who have come, let's receive God's grace. I want to say something to you, all right? Those who are receiving God's grace. If you feel like the Christian life is hard, doesn't mean you have fallen out of grace. It doesn't mean you're working out from your own flesh. It means that God gives us great challenges and the devil wants to stop it. So instead of saying, I just want to take a message and say, it's okay, just relax and enjoy, I tell you what, we just want to experience grace upon grace, all right? And if some of you, you're struggling with sin, struggling with depression, God tells me somebody here is struggling from depression, grace of God is enough, amen? I want to pray a prayer for you. And I want just to ask you to receive this grace, all right? Lord, if we can do it on our own, we realize we don't need you. But Lord, even as your people, we realize that we can't do it on our own. That's why your word says that you have come to give us grace upon grace, so that there will be strength upon strength. So in Jesus' name, I release a baptism of God's grace in your heart. A grace that reminds you how loved you are, how precious you are in God's sight. A grace that reminds you that there is no condemnation in Christ Jesus. And yet a grace that tells you you can grow beyond your struggle and weaknesses. You can lay them at a cross, and the cross of Jesus Christ will demolish them, all the argument against you, all the self-condemnation. The Lord just tear this away, and the Lord give you the grace to say no to sin and yes to God. The Lord give you the grace to say, I'm not made to sin, but I'm made to live for God in righteousness. And so right now, the Lord's grace changes your mind, changes your heart, empower your will, and cause you to be able to say, I will live daily on God's grace. And for some of you who are going through a tough time in the ministry or in your work, the Lord just tells you that it is in your weakness that God's strength be made perfect, because God's grace is sufficient for you. So may the grace of the Lord fill your heart. 主，让你的恩典充充满满的充满他们，直到在他们软弱当中，他们的恐惧当中，他们的缺乏平安的当中，让主你的恩典充满他们，直到他们知道你永远不会撇下他们。我们这样祷告是奉主耶稣基督的名， Amen. Come on, let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord. Is that one? Is that one more song? Is that one more song? Last one. Come on, let's sing one more song before we go. Isn't that good? Look at what God is doing in our church. Look at the people. Look at so many lives have been touched. So let's just, as we go, let's just worship the Lord as the celebration team leads us.
Hallelujah. Today is declared as a happy day because He has washed away all our sins. Hallelujah.
Yes. It's a happy day.